Oh yeah, family, it's morning time. Welcome to the celebration, morning motivation. I am Deacon Ford, and we're here once again to give God all glory, all honor, all praise. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. It's morning time, family. Let's get into this word, see what the word say. Good morning to you, Brother Pree, Deacon Doc. I see you on here, Brother Terrence. Brother Theodore, good morning to you. Sister Natasha, good morning time. Oh, y'all, get into the word, y'all. See what the word say. Good morning to you. Make sure you hit that share button. It is morning time. You see it? Y'all see it? It's in the word right now. And it's in red. Good morning to you. Good morning, good morning, good morning to you. My big sis, good morning to you, Sister Augusta. It is morning time. Oh, yeah. Morning to you, Sister Allie. Sister Stephanie, good morning to you. It is morning time. Brother Amos, good morning to you. Sister Natasha, good morning to you. Thank y'all for hitting that share button. Those who, you know, find it in their heart to put the word out there, to share it so that maybe somebody else who isn't connected to a family like our family, I'm gonna say that again, that's not connected to a family like our family, you know, a family where we come together and we fellowship and we get into God's word, that they may feel, you know, welcome to join us. The Melko to be a part of the morning motivational family, to jump into the views, you know, maybe like, maybe share, maybe comment, maybe jump into the, you know, the comment section and be a part of the community. So thank y'all for hitting that share button. Thank y'all for being a part of the family. Once again, we are here to give God all glory, all honor, all praise. For this right here is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. We are celebrating the breath of life. Like my brother Emory say, man, we're celebrating the present. This gift of God, this is the present. And so we're celebrating this present. We unwrapping this present this morning together. All of us is in this space together. Shout out to you, Sister Roundtree. Good morning to you. Good morning to those who are going to log on from Instagram, YouTube, Big John Russ, my niece Daisy. Good morning to you, Sister Cheyenne, Mother and Deacon Robinson. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. My cousin Erica, I see you on here. Good morning to y'all. There's so many of y'all that I wish I could name y'all all, but guess what I can do? Come on in. I could give y'all a big hug, man. Good morning to you. Big hug to you, Sister Precious. Good morning, good morning, good morning to y'all. Big hug to everyone, man. This morning, y'all, we in Luke. We in Luke chapter 12. We're looking at verse 39 and 40. Luke chapter 12, verse 39 and 40. May y'all grab your word. It is so imperative. It's imperative that you get into the word for yourself. This is a corporate thing. We can all come on here together, but at the end of the day, it's about individuality. It's about an individual relationship that you have with the Heavenly Father for yourself. So that's why I always stress, don't take my word for it, but get into the word for yourself, y'all. Don't take my word for it, get into the word for yourself. So that's Luke chapter 12. We are looking at this morning, verses 39 and 40. Shout out to y'all, man. Once again, those who are still logging on, I see. That's every time I get ready to get into it, I see more people keep on signing in. I see you all here, Sister Sharon. Good morning to you. Good morning to you. Good morning to each and every single one of y'all. Evangelist Pons, good morning to you. Missionary Jackson, good morning to you. Deaconess Petronello, I see you on here, cuz TK. Good morning to you. Good morning to you, Sister LaShawn. Let's get into this word, y'all. Luke chapter 12, verse 39 and 40. Let us pray. God, our Father, as we humbly come before you this morning, in the mighty strong name of your Son, Christ the Messiah, we ask, God, that you will bless us with wisdom, knowledge, and understanding of the things that we read, O God, that your Holy Spirit will guide us into all truth and revelation. We thank you for allowing us to have this divine appointment, this space that we could come together and we can fellowship one with another. We ask that the word that we read, that it take root in our heart and that we would apply it to our life. We thank you and we love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Once again, y'all, we're looking at Luke. Hey, I love you too, man, TK. We're looking at Luke chapter 12, verses 39 through 40. The word reads, "But know this, if the master of the house had known what hour the thief would come, he would have watched and not allowed his house to be broken into. Therefore, you also be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect." Let me read that again. Boy, y'all know, look at it. If you want your word, y'all see this in red. So this is what Jesus said. "But know this, if the master of the house had known what hour the thief would come, he would have watched and not allowed his house to be broken into. Therefore, you also be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect." May God add a blessing to the reading, the hearer, but most importantly, the doer of his holy word. It gives a beautiful, picture. He paints this picture that is so clear. He said, if the master of the house, the one who owned the house, the owner of the house, knew what time a thief was about to come into his house and break into his house, he would have stayed home and waited on him to make sure that he didn't break into his house. That's what he said. This is what he said. If he knew it, he would have made it his business to be there to make sure that when the thief tried to come break in, that he would post it right there and let him see his face. And we know 9 times out of 10, the thief would have turned around and went the other way, or probably went to find another house who wasn't on point as this master was. It says, then it goes, but be ready. Be ready. Therefore, you get ready. Therefore, we get ready. That P, correct. You got it, Sister LaShawn. That P, preparation. Y'all know it's a wrap for the foolishness. Reflection, accountability, application of what? Preparation. It says, therefore, you also be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. Be ready. How do we get prepared? What are we doing to prepare for the coming of the Son of Man? How are we living our life? What are we doing? How are we interacting with our loved ones, our community, those that we work with, our co-workers? Huh? How are we interacting with our neighbors? You know, throughout the New Testament, we see that Jesus stressed a lot about our neighbor. Love thy neighbor as you love yourself. It says, do unto them as you would have them do unto you. It spoke a lot about, you know, community and fellowship and coming together and neighborly love. How are we expressing that? How are we doing that? Because it says we got to be ready. When the time comes, it's going to be too late to go get ready. How are we preparing? What are we doing right now? Are you ready? Or is you still out there trying to work, still trying to get things together? And it ain't nothing wrong with that. It's nothing wrong with that if you can acknowledge the fact that I got some things that I'm working on, but at least you're getting prepared. It's wrong when you know it's some stuff that you need to be working on and you disregarding those things. That's when it's wrong. When you know that there are things that you should be working on, things that you should be diligently looking into, seeking solutions for, putting time and effort in, and you disregarding that. That's when it's wrong. But if you know there's areas of your life that I need improvement on, and hey man, I've acknowledged that I have an issue in that area. That's the first thing you always got to do. If you can't even acknowledge, if you can't even talk about when it's brought to your attention, and the first thing you do is you get defensive, then bruh, sis, you would go headed in the wrong direction. You headed in the wrong direction. But if you know that there's areas in your life that you should be working on, and you at least took the initiative to acknowledge and start to seek out what type of help you need and what helping looks like in that area, man, you're getting ready. But listen, man, don't take too long. Don't take too long saying that I'm getting ready, I'm getting prepared, I'm making an effort, I'm thinking about it, and you never hit that go button. It's time to hit that go button, y'all. It's time to really kick this thing into gear. God has blessed us. I'm telling you, like Brother Emery, I'm going to say it again. Like Bruh said, today is the present. This is a gift from God. We don't know. Man, listen, I was home on vacation, and I was speaking with a brother. We just so happened to get into the elevator together. And me and the brother, you know how it is, just a little small talk. And me and the brother were talking, and Bruh say, man, we used to be able to say, you know what I'm saying, one day at a time. We live one day at a time. But now we got to say we live one moment at a time. That's all we got is a moment. We don't know what the next moment may bring. That's how fast time is moving. This is the type of dimension that we're living in right now. So we don't got a lot of time, man, to start putting stuff together. We don't got that. You could miss your opportunity. You could miss your blessing because you're not getting prepared. Be ready. Be ready. Put in that work. Get ready and be ready. Therefore, you also be ready, for the Son of Man is coming in an hour you do not expect. For the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. Therefore, you also be ready. Like that man was the owner of the house. He said if he know when the thief was coming, he wouldn't have never allowed him to break in and steal. You ain't tired of people. Oh, hallelujah. You ain't tired of people breaking in and stealing. You ain't tired of people breaking in and stealing. They stealing your joy. They stealing your peace. They stealing your mental and your emotional stability. It ain't about material stuff that they stealing from you. They stealing the contentment of, oh, hallelujah. They stealing the contentment of your heart. You ain't tired of that. Huh? You ain't tired of it? You ain't tired of stealing it from yourself, not allowing yourself to be happy? Oh, you so used to drama and trauma that you create your own situation? You ain't used to that? I mean, I know I don't want you to be used to that. Don't get used to that. It's time to get ready. It's time to get prepared. Therefore, you also be ready. Time to put that work in, man. I love y'all. God bless you. We finna sign up off of here, man. Luke chapter 12, 39-4. That was for somebody this morning. I'm somebody. That was for somebody this morning. I'm somebody. That was for me, man. I don't know who else that was for. That was time to, you know, get ready. It's a wrap. Reflection, accountability, application, and preparation. Hello, somebody. I'm somebody this morning. For real. Don't take my word for it. Get into it for yourself. When you read your word, jump into the comment box and say, I read my word. Y'all see what it say on the wall over there, right? Faith over fear. God over everything. Together, we have made love great again. Love has never lost its power. It's lost its popularity, man. I love y'all. God bless you. Y'all come on in, man. It's a little emotional this morning. I kind of feel it. Yeah. I ain't gonna tell you no lie. When I was getting prepared this morning for the word, I was like, man, this thing gonna cut kind of deep. I already know it. I say this thing gonna cut kind of deep. You know what I'm saying? For those who really pay attention, who just ain't really logging on, you know, just hanging out in the community, just hanging out, you know, morning motivation. But those who really logging on with a purpose, I knew that they were gonna cut kind of deep. You know what I'm saying? But that's what we need. We need that. We need that hard love. We need that tough love so we can get better. I know I'm desiring better for my life. I know I'm desiring better for my wife. I know I'm desiring better for my children. I know I'm desiring better for my family. I know I'm desiring better for my community. I know I'm desiring better for this world. So sometimes it's going to get cut kind of deep. It's going to get a little bit uncomfortable. But we're going to put that work in so that we will be ready. Man, I love y'all, man. Come in, man. Come in. Oh, y'all come in real quick. Big hug to y'all, man. Big hug to each and every single one of y'all. I love y'all. God bless you. If y'all don't mind, y'all hit that share button, man. Somebody need to hear this, man. Somebody. I'm somebody. Signing off, y'all. Morning time. Morning time. It is morning time. Love y'all. I see you on here, Sandy. You know I love you. So, Lucy. Sandra, good morning to you. Sister Candace, good morning to you. Morning time, fam.